About 23 years ago, there was an Aussie bloke. He picked up his swag, and he's a Cobra, and he's dry as a bone, and he headed for Miami Beach, Florida, to live in a drag queen. When he arrived, he laid his swag down on this beautiful black and white checkered floor, surrounded by mannequins and scarves and colour and dresses and wigs. Lots and lots of wigs. That night, this drag queen said to this Aussie bloke, "Sit down, watch the news," while he, or she, created the wig of the night. This drag queen had to innovate, had to change every single night. This went on for months. Every now and then, this Aussie bloke might even end up with a little phallic symbol on his head. It's a true story. This Aussie bloke, it was me. Let me get a quick snapshot of that one. Studies show that we have up to about 70,000 thoughts a day. Some even say more. 70,000 thoughts a day, no wonder we're tired, right? But the exciting part about that is 95% of those 70,000 thoughts are actually the same as yesterday. It's like Groundhog Day. This is the part where I should be putting up a picture of someone famous. Someone who took one of those thoughts and converted it to an idea and did something amazing. Changed the world forever. Over 200 years ago. Thank you. But I'm not going to do that. Instead, I want to talk about you. In hope that 200 years, it'll be your face up there instead. So, in this room, show of hands, who's had an idea and done absolutely nothing about it? Well, usually 60%, it's 80% of this audience. Why is this? That's rhetorical, we don't have to answer. Why is this? What about we create an ideas ecosystem and we promote it to the world and we call it prototype to product? Imagine if the world could come to Australia with your ideas and convert their ideas into a prototype for free. Why? Because the kicker is once they have that prototype, they then have to produce that product or technology here in Australia. Would that not make Australia one of the most innovative countries in the world? Yeah, that's not a rhetorical thing. It really would, I believe. And this is why I believe it would. I asked you a question a minute ago, did you have an idea and do nothing about it? And 80% of the audience said yes. And done nothing about it, 80% of the audience said yes. Now I'm going to ask you again, if you had that idea, and you could get your idea to prototype for free, would you do it?
Yes.
Yes, you would. I believe that's the answer. Turning your ideas into action is, I believe, a bit of a cycle. And I've come up with an acronym for that. I love an acronym. And it's called winning. It has an interesting but, a difficult but, I'm lucky enough over the years I've been involved in small business, corporate business, and I've even invented a product and taken it global. And I keep getting asked the question, how did you do that? And I think it's the wrong question. I think the question needs to be, why did I do it? Why is your passion? Why is your promotion? Why is your team? And at the end of the day, why is why you had the idea in the first place. I for idea. Adults are very good at having ideas, but we're not very good at flowing through and actually finishing those ideas. And there's a reason for that, and it's called a fact. We're very scared of facts, adults. Whereas education departments, universities and schools, and especially kids, cultivate. They love ideas. And you know why? It's because they have no boundaries. They take it. They take those ideas and do something with them. My kids are 7 and 9, and about 6 months ago, they borrowed my phone. They went away for half an hour. They came back and they said, "Dad, sit down, have a look at this." I sat down. What they had done was they had taken a broom and a mop, put it together, taped it up, and said, "Look, you can broom and mop at the same time." We called it the mop. It's a true story. We'll quick change that before you paint it. It is. What they did then was move very quickly to the end stage, which is your network stage. So their network was mum and dad, nan and pop, and grandma, and a few of their friends. By the way, the mop now has a coffee machine, just in case you get tired after you have a coffee at the same time as bringing it up. The network. Your network is really important. Your network is quite vast. You probably don't realise if you sit there and go, "Oh, no." If you think about all the years you went to school and who you've met and who you've engaged with over the years, your network is massive. And you've got to use that network to get that idea. But be careful. This is what I call the research stage. It's not the decision-making stage, it's the research stage. It's where you're going to ask them, "What do you think? Is it exciting? Yeah, is it good? All that sort of good stuff." Get the good out of it. Because you're going to move very fast to the second end. I'm going to take you back 100 years to World War I, to the trenches. In between the trenches, there's an area of land, and that area of land's called no man's land. Correct. No man's land. And no disrespect to the soldiers of the day, I want to use this analogy because I believe it's where ideas and innovation are killed before they come anywhere. So, imagine your ideas. Come with me on this journey. You know why you're there, you know the idea you have, and you're with your network. You're in the trenches. You're about to tell everyone about your idea. Are you scared? Yeah. Because you should be. When you come up out of that trench, the very first thing that happens is bang. No, that's not a good idea. Most ideas die right then. You go, "Yeah, you're right. But the second wave of troops move forward. They're still going. And the bullets are going past them, and they're getting barbed wire, and they're getting cuts. No, it's not a good idea. No, it's too expensive. And my personal favourite, no, it's been done before. But they don't care. You keep moving until, bang, you get one in the leg. You're down. You sit there, it's the last no. No, you know what? This is just too hard. I have my research, I've done that, it's too many no's, it's negative. And then what do? Nothing about it. So, the last phase. They see that trench, the last group. This is the ones that actually take their ideas and do something with them. They see that trench and they jump in it with their network. And that's the part where you innovate. That's the exciting part. That's where you get that idea and rip it apart. You go, "Is it the best it can be? Should we change it? Should we do something with it?" And that's the exciting phase. You very quickly move into the last part, or the second last, which is N for now, the how. The how's very last. How are we going to make it? How are we going to manufacture it? How are we going to get our chain supply right? How are we going to market it? How are we going to, most important, how are we going to sell it? That's now the how. That's last. Passion first. So I want to leave you with a couple of things. One is, where are you in the cycle of your idea? Second one, can we, could we, is it possible that we could create an ideas ecosystem here in Australia to innovate and make ideas come and turn them into action? And the last one is a G. Go for it. Thanks very much.